files in Teams. Are you a bit confused with all the places that there is to store files in Teams? And maybe a little confused about how to access those files, delete them, or change them, and that kind of thing? Well, I'm going to take you through a quick little tour of the places that you can find this in your Teams app, and then hopefully that'll help you move forward and use your files the way they're meant to be. So let's start here. Right now, I'm in the Teams. I'm clicked on Teams on the left-hand side here. I'm in the general channel. And if I go to files up top here, these files that are in Teams are really stored in SharePoint. Maybe you've heard this a few times already, but files that you save within the Teams channel are stored within the SharePoint file attached to that team. And so what happens is if I wanted to edit that file or delete that file or move that file, by clicking on the three dots beside the file, I have those kinds of options, including open in SharePoint. So we'll get back to this a little bit later why you'd want to do that. Now let's look at where else you have files. So that's one area. Let's go somewhere else. We're going to go to chat on the left. And if you attach a file when you're chatting, you say, hey, look at the spreadsheet for me, then that file gets stored in the files area of that chat. So in this example here, let's go to Project XYZ group, and then we'll go to files, and you'll see there's a number of files in here. And if I click on the same three dots, I don't have the same options. This is not the same. This isn't letting me move them around. It's not letting me delete them. It's not letting me do different things. So I have different kinds of permissions here. And by the way, where these files are stored is different than when you have those files in Teams. In Teams, the files were stored in SharePoint. When you add files here, these files are stored in OneDrive. And it's OneDrive of the person that uploaded the file, provided they have OneDrive for business. It doesn't work with OneDrive personal. So if you're trying to use this, then that might be some of the issues you might have. But OneDrive for business. Okay, so let me show you those things in a minute. I'm gonna go one more place and then I'll kind of give you the background view of this. So the third place I wanted to show you in terms of where files exist, or you see that word within Teams, is on the left-hand side here. So if I click on files here, this is not letting me, if I click on the arrows, the three dots, sorry, it doesn't let me edit. I can edit the file, but I can't delete it or move it or those kinds of things or rename it. This is kind of like a shortcut area. And so the first area that I'm in says recent. So this is just showing me all the files that I've opened recently that are associated with Teams or SharePoint or even OneDrive. Plus, it lets me access other cloud storage areas if I have them connected. So this is not for editing. If you wanted to go back to this file, group example, for instance, and you wanted to actually delete that file, you don't want it anymore, you cannot do it here. You have to go where it originated from. Did it originate in a chat or did it originate in a team channel? So let's just say one of these files originated in a Teams channel. I'm gonna go back there. Let's go back to Teams. And within Teams, I can get rid of a file. Let's take testing here. And I'm gonna hit the three dots and I'm gonna hit delete. Now, this is something you really need to know. Everybody that's a member of this team and a guest of this team and an owner of this team can delete this file. Unless you've changed the permissions in the background, unless you've done some fancy stuff within SharePoint, the SharePoint site, unless you have your IT department or team on top of this, by default, everybody part of the team can add files and delete files. So you need to understand this. If you hit delete on your phone when you're looking at your Teams files, you've deleted it from the entire team from the SharePoint site as well. It's gone. And it's not gone forever. I'll show you how to get it back. But it is gone from this area. So everyone can delete as a default. Let's just say it that way. So I'm going to hit delete. And it says you want to go to the site recycle bin. So I'll say, OK, delete. Well, there is no recycle bin in Teams. Now, unless Teams Microsoft changes this, right now the site recycle bin is talking about is the SharePoint site that's associated with Teams, because Teams is not saving these files for you. These files are really in SharePoint. So the site recycle bin is really about the SharePoint site. So now if I'm going, oh, I shouldn't have deleted that file, and it's telling me I deleted something, because I'm still in this files area here, I can go to open in SharePoint. So watch what happens when I do this. So I get access to the same exact files here. And now I can go over to the left side here. It says recycle bin, click on that. And there's that testing file that I'm like, oh goodness, okay, I can get it back. So I can click on that file and then restore it so it goes back into the team. Now, from your iPhone, I don't, you'd have to know how to maneuver within SharePoint on your iPhone. I haven't tested this to see if all the buttons are the same on there, but on your computer, this is how it's gonna behave. All right, so that's how easily you can bring it back. Let's go back to Teams. And let's go back to files within a chat. So if I go to the chat files and then look at the drop down there, I don't have the delete option here. So where were these files stored? Do you remember? Not in SharePoint, they're stored in your OneDrive folder, business OneDrive folder. So if I go to my OneDrive folder, I'm gonna take you there now. I have a OneDrive folder called Microsoft Teams chat files. So if I click on that, that shows me all the files that I have within any of my chats that I uploaded to a Teams chat. Okay, so that's where all of these are. And this is where I can delete that file. I can't delete it within the Teams area. Okay, and then lastly, just to review, if I go to files here, I can certainly see files, I can open the files, work on the files, but I cannot delete them from here. I have to go back to where they originated, which means they originated either in OneDrive or in SharePoint, and a particular team site, team channel, might be the best way to find that, or a particular chat, okay? So by the way, it is giving you a hint here. If you notice, location is a column. So this one's saying this one's in my OneDrive. This one is not in OneDrive. Mission training, if I want to refer to where that is. If I go to Teams, I have a mission team, right? And training is the channel. If I go to files, assessment results is right there. So that's how you can kind of figure out, well, where is that file? It's telling you where the file is. It's telling you right here in the location area. So just look there. All right, so hopefully you enjoyed that quick little lesson on the differences within your team's environment of where files is. And this helps you maneuver around better. If you need to change your permissions so that not everybody can delete a file, that is going to be in one of my next lessons on SharePoint and permissions for files on SharePoint and Teams. So stay tuned for that. Look for that video, and you can find out more there. Thanks. Bye-bye.